Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel JK EduHub. In this video we are going to see the history of the world from Big Bang to recent Corona pandemic. It includes most of the important events in human history. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. So let's start. The timeline of the early universe outlines the formation and subsequent evolution of the universe from the Big Bang around 14 billion years ago. 9.2 billion years formation of Earth-Moon system following giant impact by hypothetical planetoid Theia planet. Around 4,400 million years ago we found first appearance of liquid water on Earth. Around 4,280 million years ago earliest possible appearance of life on Earth formed. The first humans emerged in Africa around 2 million years ago, long before the modern humans known as Homo sapiens appeared on the same continent. Modern human beings, called Homo sapiens the wise man, have lived for about 250,000 years. The first Homo sapiens lived at the same time as other species of human. These included Homo erectus the standing man and Homo neanderthalensis man from Neanderthal. They were a little bit different from modern humans. The Paleolithic era is by far the longest age of humanity's time, about 99% of human history. The Paleolithic age started about 2.6 million years ago and ended around 10,000 BC. The age began when hominids, early humans, started to use stones as tools for bashing, cutting and scrapping. During the Paleolithic era humans grouped together in small bands. They lived by gathering plants and hunting wild animals. This way of living is called a hunter-gatherer society. People hunted small burrowing animals like rabbits, as well as birds and herds of animals like deer and cattle. They also gathered plants to eat, including grains. Grain often grows on grasslands where herds of grass-eating animals are found. People also gathered root vegetables, green vegetables, beans, fruit, seeds, berries, nuts, eggs, insects and small reptiles. Paleolithic people used stone tools. Sometimes a stone tool was just a rock. It might have been useful for smashing a shell or an animal's skull, or for grinding grain on another rock. Other tools were made by breaking rocks to make a sharp edge. The next development in stone tool making was to chip all the edges of a rock so that it made a pointed shape, useful for a spearhead, or arrow tip. The Neolithic era was marked by changes in society. During the Neolithic era, people started to settle down. They developed agriculture and domesticated animals, both of which took a very long time. Because of these two things, people did not have to migrate as much anymore. Villages could grow to much larger sizes than before. Over time, villages fought and spread their control over larger areas and some became civilizations. During this time, humankind also developed further intellectually, militarily and spiritually. When humans started to grow crops and domesticate certain animals such as dogs, goats, sheep, and cattle, their societies changed. Because people now grew crops and raised livestock, they started to stay in the same place and build permanent settlements. In most places, this happened between 10,000 and 12,000 years ago. Civilizations around this time were also built along major river systems. These civilizations are called River Valley Civilizations. River Valley Civilizations were the most powerful civilizations in this time period because water was needed to have an agricultural society. Sumer was the world's first known ancient civilization. The Sumerians took over the Fertile Crescent region of Mesopotamia around 3300 BCE. By 3000 BCE, many cities had been built in parts of Sumerian Mesopotamia. They formed independently and each had their own government. They were called city-states and often fought with each other. Sumer grew crops on the Tigris and Euphrates rivers. A surplus in food led to a division of labor. This means that some people were able to stop growing crops and do other jobs, since enough crops were already grown. This brought a split in society. Today, such a split is called social pyramid. In a social pyramid, people are grouped into social classes based on their wealth and power. The Sumerians created the world's first system of writing. It was called cuneiform. The oldest versions of one of the world's first literary works, the Epic of Gilgamesh, go back to this time. They also invented sun-dried bricks, the wheel, the ox plow, and were skilled at making pottery. They are also thought to have invented the sailboat. Ancient Egypt grew along the Nile River and was its most powerful in the second millennium BC. When it was its biggest, it went all the way from the Nile Delta to a mountain called Jebel Barkhlan, Sudan. It was created around 3500 BC and probably ended at about 30 BC when the country was invaded by the Roman Empire. The society of ancient Egypt depended on a balance of natural and human resources, especially the irrigation of the Nile Valley so that Egyptians could grow crops. They are also known for writing in hieroglyphs, building the famous pyramids, other sorts of tombs and big temples, and for their military. There was a great difference between classes in this society. Most of the people were farmers, but they did not own the agricultural products they produced. These were property of the state, temple, or a noble family that owned the land. There was slavery, but it is not clear how it was practiced. The rulers of ancient Egypt tried to keep their people happy by religion that made them respect the rulers and their past. The religion of Judaism formed about 1500 BCE in context with the Egyptian and Babylonian civilization. The Indus Valley civilization started from about 2600 BC to 1900 BC. It marked the beginning of the urban civilization on the subcontinent. It was centered on the Indus River and its tributaries. The civilization is famous for its cities that were built of brick, had a roadside drainage system and multi-storied houses. During the Maurya dynasty started in 321 BCE, most of the Indian subcontinent was united under a single government for the first time. Ashoka the Great, who in the beginning sought to expand his kingdom, then followed a policy of ahimsa or non-violence after converting to Buddhism. The edicts of Ashoka are the oldest preserved historical documents of India, and under Ashoka Buddhist ideals spread across the whole of East Asia and Southeast Asia. The Gupta dynasty ruled from around 320 to 550 AD. The Gupta Empire included only central India, and the area east of current-day Bangladesh. However, this empire never included present-day Pakistan to the west. Gupta society was ordered in accordance with Hindu beliefs. Historians place the Gupta dynasty alongside with the Han dynasty, Tang dynasty and Roman Empire as a model of a classical civilization. The first dynasty of ancient China, the Song dynasty, has been carbon dated through turtle shells with writing on them to back to about 1500 BC. They say China began as city-states in the Yellow River Valley. At the end of the Xu dynasty lived the greatest Chinese philosophers, Confucius, founder of Confucianism, and Laozi, founder of Taoism. The Qin Emperor Qin Shi Huang in 221 BC created the first centralized state in China based on his political philosophy of legalism and made everyone write the same way. He fought against Confucianism. He also started a precursor of the Great Wall. In 202 BC the Han dynasty took over and developed an empire of similar strength as the Roman Empire, and towards the end of its rule, influenced by India, introduced Buddhism in China. The Maya civilization is a civilization that started in Central America. They lived mostly on the Yucatan Peninsula in what is now known as Mexico, but also Honduras, Belize, and Guatemala. They were the only known civilization of pre-Columbian America to have a fully developed written language. They also made great achievements in art and architecture and had a very advanced system of mathematics and astronomy. The area where the Maya civilization developed was inhabited from around the 10th millennium BC. The first Maya settlements were built there in about 1800 BC, in the Soconusco region. This is in the modern-day state of Chiapas in Mexico, on the Pacific Ocean. Today, this is called the early pre-classic period. At the time, humans began to settle down permanently. They started to grow livestock. Pottery and small clay figures were made. The Hallstatt era is named after the city Hallstatt in Austria, where the first artifacts were found. It lasted from about 1200 BC to about 275 BC. There were different periods, which today are mainly told apart by the kinds of brooches used at the time. These brooches changed rather rapidly, and can therefore give us good guesses at to what time they came from. Hallstatt culture sites have been found in the east of France, in Switzerland, in the south of Germany, in Austria, in Slovenia and Croatia, northwestern Hungary, southwestern Slovakia and southern Moravia. The culture can be divided into an eastern and a western one quite easily. The dividing line runs through the Czech Republic and Austria, between longitudes 14 and 15 degrees east. In this time, the social structure developed into a hierarchy. This can be documented by various things that were added to graves. In the Bronze Age, people used to live in big settlements. As iron became available, trade routes changed. A new richer class evolved. Unlike before, these richer class people liked to live in big houses in the countryside, as a demonstration of their wealth. Funerals also changed, from cremation burials, to burials with stone coffins. The new upper class used their wealth for import goods, mostly from the Mediterranean. The Latin culture is a culture that lasted from about 500 BC to about 100 AD. It is named after the city of Latin today, Marinepagnier, next to Neuchâtel. It was influenced a lot by the Roman and Greek cultures. Romans and Greeks came in contact with the culture. They called them Celts, usually they wrote about them. The most important work about them was written by Julius Caesar. It is called On the Gallic War. What is known today as ancient Greece is a very important period in history. Most people agree that it came after the Minoan and Mycenaean civilizations. It ended when the Romans invaded Greece, in 146 BC. Greek culture had a very powerful influence on later civilizations, especially the Romans. The Greeks developed what is now called a city-state, or a polis. There were many polises. Some of the more important ones were Athens, Sparta, Corinth, and Thebes. The word politics comes from there. It literally means, things that are about the polis. Greek cities did not have much contact with each other, because of the mountains and many islands Greece is made up of. When a city no longer had enough food to care for all its citizens, some people were sent out to set up a new city. This was called a colony. Each city was independent, and ruled by someone within that city. Colonies also looked to the city where they originally came from for guidance. When Greece went to war against the Persian Empire, there was an alliance of such city-states, against the Persians. There were also many wars between different city-states. There were many artists and philosophers who lived in that period. Most of them are still important for philosophy today. A well-known artist was Homer. He wrote epics about the war against the Trojans, and the early history of Greece. Other well-known artists were Aristophanes and Sappho. Well-known philosophers include Socrates, Plato, and Aristotle. A well-known mathematician of the time was Euclid. Statesmen of the time were Pericles and Alexander the Great. Ancient Rome was a civilization that started in modern-day Italy, in the 8th century before Christ. The civilization lasted for 12 centuries. It ended, when Mehmed II conquered Constantinople, on May 29, 1453. According to legend, the Roman civilization was founded by Romulus and Remus, in the year 753 BC. The Roman Empire developed in wars against Carthage and the Seleucid Empire. Julius Caesar conquered Gaul, modern France, and Augustus ended the Roman Republic by becoming emperor. At its biggest extent, the empire covered all of the Mediterranean. Rome became so big, because it led war against other nations and then assimilated their culture. In 293, Diocletian organized a separate administration of the western and the eastern part of the empire. The capital of the western part was Rome, the capital of the eastern part was Constantinople. Constantine I was the first to stop discrimination against Christians. Christianity became state religion under the reign of Theodosius I. The western part of the empire had many problems with barbarians. In the 5th century, the Huns migrated westwards. This meant that the Visigoths moved into the empire, to seek protection. Rome was sacked by barbarians multiple times. On September 4, 476, the Germanic chief Odoacer forced the last Roman emperor in the west, Romulus Augustus, to quit. After about 1,200 years, the rule of Rome in the west came to an end. The eastern part had similar problems. Justinian I managed to conquer parts of North Africa and Italy. Shortly after he died, all that was left were parts of southern Italy, and Sicily. In the east, the empire was threatened by the Sassanid Empire. After the fall of Western Rome, the Germanic tribes that took over tried to learn from Roman civilization, but much was forgotten and up to the Renaissance not many achievements happened in Europe. But with the rise of Islam, many changes happened during the Islamic Golden Age. The Greek and Roman traditions were kept and further development took place. The Chinese civilization had a golden age during the Tang period, when their capital was the biggest in the world. During the Renaissance, Europe developed and made great advancements in many areas as well. In Arabia, Muhammad founded Islam in 632. His followers rapidly conquered territories in Syria and Egypt. they soon were a danger to the Byzantine Empire. In the 8th and 9th centuries, the Byzantine Empire stopped Islamic expansion and reconquered some lost territories. In 1000 AD, the Eastern Empire was at its height. Basileios II reconquered Bulgaria and Armenia. Culture and trade flourished. In 1071, the Battle of Manzikert led the empire into a dramatic decline. For the Byzantine Empire, this meant centuries of civil wars and Turkic invasions. The Muslim Caliphate had a golden age under the Abbasids. Their power forced Emperor Alexius I Komnenos of the Byzantine Empire to send a call for help to the West in 1095. The West sent the Crusades. These eventually led to the sack of Constantinople and the Fourth Crusade in 1204. Because of this, what was left of the empire broke into successor states. The winner of these disputes was that of Nicaea. After Constantinople was again conquered by imperial forces, the empire was little more than a Greek state on the Aegean coast. The Eastern Empire came to an end when Mehmed II conquered Constantinople on May 29, 1453. The Ottoman Empire took its place and from 1400 to 1600 was the most powerful empire in the Middle East and ruled at the southern and eastern coast of the Mediterranean Sea. In China, the Tang Dynasty with its capital at Qing'an today's and was the biggest city in the world at the time and is considered by historians as a high point in Chinese civilization as well as a golden age of cosmopolitan culture. The Ming Dynasty ruled from 1368 to 1644. The Ming built a vast army and navy. In India from around the 6th-7th century. In South India, Chola kings ruled Tamil Nadu, and Chola kings ruled Kerala. They had trading relationships with the Roman Empire to the west and Southeast Asia to the east. In North India, Rajputs ruled in many kingdoms. In 1336, two brothers named Harihara and Bukka founded the Vijayanagara Empire in an area which is now in the Karnataka state of India. The most famous king of this empire was Krishnadevarya. In 1565, rulers of this empire were defeated in a battle. But the empire continued for about the next 100 years. Northern India was ruled by Islamic sultans. The Han period in Japan is famous for its art, poetry and literature. The writing system, Kana, was developed. It was followed by the feudal period during which samurai and daimyos were the leading figures and the shogun the real monarch, whereas the Tanno had only a role as religious head. Between the years 1272 and 1281, the Mongols tried to invade but were driven out by the Japanese. 40. In 1542, a Portuguese ship reached Japan. Japanese learned about guns and firearms from them. Genghis Khan in 1209 brought together the Mongol tribes and founded the Mongol Empire, one of the largest land empires in history. Later Kublai Khan would go on to expand the empire and found the Mongol rule the Yuan Dynasty of China. The empire later broke into several empires, all of which were later destroyed. The Middle Ages was the time from the fall of the Roman Empire until the middle of the 15th century. From 500 to about 800 there was some decline compared with the Roman civilization. European villages were often destroyed and looted by barbarians such as the Vikings. During the High Middle Ages, magnificent castles and large churches called cathedrals were built and important works of literature were written. In the later Middle Ages, there was a plague called the Black Death. The Black Death killed one-third to one-half of Europe's population. A system called feudalism was a very important part of the Middle Ages. In this system, the king was at the top of the social pyramid. The king gave land to the lord in exchange for loyalty. The lords were the next in the pyramid. The lords gave land, called a fief, to knights in exchange for loyalty and protection. The knights came next in the pyramid. Peasants were not part of the feudal system because they did not give or receive land. They worked on the lord's manor in exchange for protection. The Crusades were also fought during the Middle Ages. There is a theory that says the Crusades helped end the Middle Ages along with the Black Death, increased trade and better farming technology. The Renaissance started in Italy during 14th century. Renaissance is a French word meaning rebirth. The Renaissance meant that people learned from the ancient Greek and Roman or classical cultures that had been forgotten for some time. Artists learned from classical paintings and sculptures. So they reinvented perspective and the art of freestanding realistic sculptures that had been characteristic in Greek and Roman art. Some famous Renaissance artists are Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo, and Raphael. The Gutenberg printing press, invented by Johannes Gutenberg, was also developed during this time. The Renaissance was also a time of great achievements. In science, Galileo Galilei, Francis Bacon; in philosophy, Thomas More; in literature, Dante Alighieri, William Shakespeare are prominent names. What is known as the classical period lasted from about 250 to about 900. During this time, many monuments were constructed. There are also many big inscriptions from then. In this period, the Maya moved to building large cities. This is known as urbanism. Many important intellectual and artistic developments happened in an area that is known as the Southern Lowlands. Like the ancient Greek, the Maya civilization was made of many independent city-states. Agriculture was important around these city-states like Tikal and Copan. The most important monuments are the pyramids they built in their religious centers and the palaces of their rulers. The palace at Kankuan is the largest in the Maya area. There are no pyramids in the area of the palace. Other important things the archaeologists found include the carved stone slabs usually called stelae. The Maya called them Titan, or tree stones. These slabs show rulers along with hieroglyphic texts describing their genealogy, military victories, and other accomplishments. In North America, they made Mississippian culture with the largest landfill from around 800 CE to 1600. In the 8th and 9th century, the cities in the southern lowlands had problems, and declined. At the same time, the Maya stopped making big monuments and inscriptions. Shortly afterwards, these cities were abandoned. Currently, archaeologists are not sure why this happened. There are different theories. Either ecological factors played a role in this, or the cause of this abandonment was not related to the environment. The Aztecs built an empire in Central America, mainly in Mexico. The empire lasted from the 14th to the 16th century. They spoke the Nahuatl language. The capital was Tenochtitlan. It was built on islands in a lake. Tenochtitlan was one of the greatest cities of the world in that time. The Aztecs believed in polytheism. Quetzalcoatl, feathered snake; Huitzilopochtli, hummingbird of the south; and Tezcatlipoca, smoking mirror, were the most important gods. Sometimes the Aztecs killed humans to please their gods. Between 1519 and 1521, the Spanish leader Hernan Cortes defeated the Aztecs and took their empire. Some Aztecs did not want to fight against the soldiers of Cortes, because they thought they were gods. Colonization happened after Christopher Columbus came to the Americas. European countries such as England, France, and Spain built colonies in the Americas. These settlers fought the Native Americans to take over their land. The colonization of the Americas was the beginning of modern times. An important part about contact with the Americas was the Columbian Exchange. The Columbian Exchange brought new foods, ideas, and diseases to the Old World and New World, changing the way people lived. Historians believe that almost everyone as far as Asia was affected in some way by the Columbian Exchange. The Industrial Revolution started in Great Britain in 1760. It brought many advances in the way goods were produced. These advances allowed people to produce much more than they needed for living. The early British Empire split as its colonies in America revolted to establish a representative government. The French Revolution in 1789 led to massive political change in continental Europe, as people following the ideas of Enlightenment asked for human rights with the slogan Liberty, Equality, Fraternity. That led to the Declaration of the Rights of Man and of the Citizen, but also to terror and the execution of King Louis XVI. The French leader, Napoleon Bonaparte, conquered and changed Europe through war up to 1815. As more and more small property holders were granted the vote, in France and the UK, socialist and trade union activity developed and revolution gripped Europe in 1848. The last vestiges of serfdom were abolished in Austria-Hungary in 1848. Russian serfdom was abolished in 1861. The Balkan nations began to regain their independence from the Ottoman Empire. After the Franco-Prussian War, Italy and Germany became unified in 1870 and 1871. Conflict spread across the globe, in a chase for empires. The search for a place in the sun ended with the outbreak of World War I. In the desperation of war, the Russian Revolution promised the people peace, bread and land. The defeat of Germany came at the price of economic destruction, which was written down in the Treaty of Versailles. From 1644 to 1912, the Qing or Manchu dynasty ruled China. The dynasty was founded by the Manchu clan in northeast China, Manchuria. It expanded into China proper and its surrounding territories, establishing the Empire of the Great Qing. its military power weakened during the 1800s, and faced with international pressure, massive rebellions and defeats in worse, the Qing dynasty declined after the mid-19th century. It was overthrown in 1912. During the Edo period, Japan had many small rulers. There were about 200 of them, called the daimyo. Out of them, the Tokugawa clan was most powerful. They ruled from a place called Eto. This place was around the present-day's Tokyo. For 15 generations they were the most powerful clan in Japan. Beginning from the early 17th century, the rulers known as shogunate started a policy of seclusion, stopping some people coming in, known as sikoku in Japanese language. They suspected that traders, merchants and missionaries wanted to bring Japan under the control of European powers. Except the Dutch and the Chinese, all foreigners, traders and merchants from other countries, missionaries were no longer allowed into Japan. Still, even during the period of seclusion, Japanese continued to gain information and knowledge about other parts of the world. This policy of seclusion lasted for about 200 years. It ended 1868 with Meiji Restoration, when the emperor took over again and started a lot of reforms. In India, the Mughal Empire existed from 1526 to 1857. When it was biggest, it ruled most of the Indian subcontinent, then known as Hindustan, and parts of what is now Afghanistan. It was founded by Babur in 1526 and ruled until 1530. Its most important ruler was Akbar, 1556 to 1605. After the death of Aurangzeb, 1658 to 1707, the Mughal Empire became weak. It continued until 1857. By that time, India came under the British Raj. The Taj Mahal was built around 1648 by Shah Jahan. Settlement by the Spanish started the European colonization of the Americas. It meant genocide of the native Indians. The Spanish gained control of most of the Caribbean and conquered the Aztecs. So they founded the Spanish Empire in the New World. The first successful English settlements were in North America at Jamestown, Virginia, 1607, along with its satellite, Bermuda, in 1609, and Plymouth, Massachusetts, 1620. The first French settlements were Port Royal, 1604, and Quebec City, 1608. The fur trade soon became the primary business on the continent and as a result transformed the Native Americans' lifestyle. Plantation slavery of the West Indies led to the beginning of the Atlantic slave trade. Rivalry between the European powers created a series of wars on the North American landmass. The American Revolution led to the creation of the United States of America. Spain's hold on its colonies weakened till it had to give them independence. The United States expanded quickly to the West. At the same time, British built more in Canada. During the 15th century, the Portuguese began exploring Africa. At the Guinea coast they built their first fort in 1482. They started slave trade after the first European contact with America in 1492 to supply settlers from there with workers. Soon English, Spanish, Dutch, French and Danish merchants also built forts. But their influence on the inland was minor till during the 19th century larger colonies were founded. The 20th century was a very important time in history. New technology and different ideas led to many worldwide changes in the time of just 100 years. The First World was a war fought from 1914 to 1918. During the time of the war, it was called the Great War, or the War to End All Wars. Chemical poisons, tanks, aeroplanes, and bombs were used for the first time. There were four main causes of the war. Imperialism, nationalism, alliances and militarism. These were causes that made it likely that a war would start in Europe. The spark that started the war was the assassination of the heir to the throne in Austria-Hungary, Archduke Franz Ferdinand, by a group of young Serbians. Austria-Hungary declared war on Serbia and each country's allies then joined the war. This created a bigger conflict which turned into World War I. Europe divided into two groups of allies, the Central Powers and the Allied Powers, the Allies. The Central Powers were made up of Germany, Austria-Hungary, the Ottoman Empire and Bulgaria. The Allies were made up of Britain, France, Russia, Italy and the United States. World War I was fought on two fronts, the Eastern Front and the Western Front. Trench warfare was commonly used on the Eastern Front. Because of a British blockade, Germany began using U-boats, or submarines, to sink British ships. After the sinking of two ships with Americans on board, and the public release of the Zimmermann Note, the U.S. declared war on Germany, joining the Allies. On November 11, 1918, Germany signed the armistice, meaning the laying down of arms, to end the war. After the war ended, the Treaty of Versailles was written and Germany was made to sign it. They had to pay $33 million in reparations. The influenza pandemic of 1918 spread around the world, killing millions. After the First War, the German Empire, the Russian Empire, the Ottoman Empire and Austrian Empire ended and France and Britain got weaker. The 1920s and 1930s had military-related fascist dictators take control of Italy, Germany, Japan, and Spain. They were helped by the Great Depression starting in 1929. When Hitler in 1933 had gained power in Germany, he prepared World War II. The Second World War was most distressed of all the wars ever fought. World War II involved the most countries and killed the most people. More than 60 million people died, making it the worst disaster of all time. It lasted 6 years in Europe, from 1939 to 1945. It was fought between the Axis powers Germany, Italy and Japan and the Allied powers. At first the Axis powers were successful, but that ended in Europe with the Battle of Stalingrad in 1943 and the invasion in Normandy in 1944. But Hitler was able to pursue his plan to annihilate Jews nearly all over Europe. Today, this plan is called the Holocaust. In the Pacific it ended with the battles of Midway and Guadalcanal. Germany surrendered on May 8. The Soviet invasion of Japan led Japan to surrender on August 15, 1945. After World War II, the United Nations was founded in the hope that it could solve arguments among nations and keep wars from happening. Communism spread to Central and Eastern Europe, Yugoslavia, Bulgaria, Romania, Albania, North Vietnam, and North Korea. In 1949, China became communist. During the 1950s and 1960s, many Third World countries became communist. This led to the Cold War, a 40-year argument between the United States, the Soviet Union, and their allies, mainly countries that were members of NATO or the Warsaw Pact. Each country wanted to promote their type of government. The Soviet Union wanted to spread communism, and the United States wanted to spread democracy. People across the world feared a nuclear war because of the tension. Communism became less popular when it became clear that it could not promote economic growth as well as Western states and that it was not suited for a reform that allowed freedom of speech for everybody. Therefore, the Soviet Union forced Hungary to give up its reform in 1956, it favored the building of the Berlin Wall in 1961 and it stopped reform in Czechoslovakia in 1968. The Berlin Wall was torn down in 1989 and the Soviet Union collapsed, 1991. Then the United States was the only superpower left. After Mao Zedong's death, China's Communist Party proved that economic reform was possible without political freedom and paved the way for enormous economic growth. As the 20th century ended, the European Union began to rise and included former satellite states and even parts of the Soviet Union. States in Asia, Africa and South America tried to copy the European Union. The 20th century was a time of great progress in terms of technology. People began to live longer because of better medicine and medical technology. New communications and transportation technologies connected the world. But these advances also helped cause problems with the environment. The last half of this century had smaller wars. Improved information technology and globalization increased trade and cultural exchange. Space exploration expanded through the solar system. The structure of DNA was discovered. The same period also raised questions about the end of human history because of global dangers, nuclear weapons, greenhouse effect and other problems in the environment. As the 20th century ended, globalization has continued. During this period, communications with mobile phones and the internet have expanded, which has led to fundamental social changes in corporation, political, and individuals' personal lives. Due to the population of growth and industrialization, worldwide resource competition is becoming increasingly highly, especially in India, China, and Brazil. The increasing demand on the environmental degradation and global warming. A new Great Recession affected the world in the late 2000s and the early 2010s, and the COVID-19 pandemic spread in 2020, causing further economic and political disruption. Some scientists referred to this as a planetary phase of civilization,